Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This one is at Yankee Stadium on July 9th of 2017, of course. And in this game, the Milwaukee Brewers take on the New York Yankees. It was Whitey Ford Bobblehead Day. You will see that eventually, and I will go more in depth with that at the end if that is what you're looking for in this video. But for everyone else, pretty much, if you don't know already what I do, when I have my first video in a stadium, I usually label it or closely resemble it to almost like a tour kind of video. Now, I do want to say that Yankee Stadium is such a big stadium. There are four different levels. I didn't really go beyond the first level, but I am going back there later this year, so I will try to do the upper level then, and may actually have seats all the way in the fourth or upper deck for the September game, which was supposed to be played in May, but it got postponed, so we're going in September now. But anyway, I'll go more in depth about that when the time comes. So anyway, this isn't the full stadium is what I'm trying to say. Even when I went to Philly, I didn't do the whole stadium, but that was only because I didn't feel like the upper decks really had much to offer, much to film there. So I don't think I'll be going up there anytime soon unless there is actually something worthwhile to film up there besides just concourse and vendors and stuff like that. I think as far as Philly goes, I think I got everything I needed. But point is, Yankee Stadium, I'm going to have to go back there, which I am, and film some more stuff I didn't get to this time. And I pretty much used up all my time here. Yeah, pretty much most of the talking from here on out I will leave to the text on Sony Vegas. And other than that, where are some places I went to? Basically, what you'll see in this video is walking through the gate, going through the concourse a little bit. I tried to get a shot of where Aaron Judge made a dent in the Frank's Red Hot area, but you can't even... It's hard to get a shot of it from above it. In retrospect, I could have leaned my phone over a little bit, but I didn't think of that at the time. May do that next time. Did get a shot of the TV he broke, though, so there's that. And also, I got Memorial Park, a little bit more of the concourse. Got some comfy seats, which were nice. And then from there on out, it's pretty much the rest of the game, really. And I could have gotten an up-close shot of the judges' chambers because I was right there, but for some reason I didn't film it. I don't know why, but that's also something I'm going to have to do next time. But I did get a far-away shot from where I was sitting, though, so there's that. And other than that, I've talked for way too long, and just enjoy the rest of the video.
Thank you. striking out 22 batters over 21.
Catcher number 24, Gary Sanchez. Pitcher number 68, Dylan Batanzas. Pitcher number 40, Luis Severino. Second baseman, number 14, Starlin Castro. And outfielder, number 99, Aaron Judge. Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a warm round of applause for our divinity hero, Detective Carmen Tejada. And our 2017 New York Yankees All-Star. Thank you, AT&T, and thank you, Whitey. Left field, number 11, Brent Gardner. Number 11. Batting second, in right field, number 99.
Thank you. for the whole month of April. And then come back for May, mid-May.
Thank you. at Yankee Stadium. Just for the GSM IEC Stadium. Wi-Fi enabled device connect to the network and register. It's that simple.
And now, here is the stuff that I got from today. This is just the scorecard that I used. That's not really anything. Just finished filling that out, which is why it's still on the table. But the first thing here is a souvenir cup. Obviously, did have to buy it. But this is one of the coolest souvenir cups because it has all the Yankees World Series logos on it from years that they won. And obviously not all of them as I look at it now, but some of them. And I guess it kind of ties in with something that I saw in the store where periodically over this year and I guess next year as well, they're going to New Era, the company that makes the hats for MLB and most other baseball caps. They are periodically over the next 2 years releasing special World Series hats from each of the 27 years of the Yankees. And I saw a couple of them in the store today. Of course, they were like $70, so couldn't get them exactly. But yeah, this is the only thing that I really got in the store. The baseball cards, which really I only use for autographs and stuff. And actually, in the stadium, these were sold out in every single store, so I couldn't find them. But I did find a pack just like it in a store across the street for $8, which is probably cheaper than in the stadium. And one weird thing is one official souvenir stand outside this, just outside the stadium, there's still official Yankees souvenir store or whatever. They still had some, but they turned everyone away saying they're closed. So I don't understand that. This is actually a 2017 version, even though it has Jeter on the front. But you see all the players on the back. Everyone is from 2017, and I guess Jeter is a special one for, I guess, people to buy it because he's on the very front. Anyway, and the last thing is the biggest thing. I haven't even unboxed this yet. It is, message from phone. Whitey Ford Bobblehead Day, July 9th was today. I guess they really tried getting people in for this whole series against Milwaukee because they've had promotions for every single game this weekend, which is not very common, but it definitely worked today. It was almost sold out. Just take a look at the box. And I guess this is quickly going to turn into an unboxing video here. Actually, that was pretty easy. Didn't have to really rip anything. We're gonna have styrofoam all over the place. Sorry, I just need to. That's awkward. I tried pulling it out from the bag and it just unwrapped it and it's still in there. This is gonna be a mess. Yeah, I cannot grab this. I'm actually gonna bring over the trash can. As you can see, it kind of made mess everywhere. I'll be back when I make some progress here. Okay, we have made some progress. Literally, all I did was just push up from the bottom, and it seemed to have broken a little bit. So you can actually get the whole block up instead of just ripping apart tiny pieces of styrofoam that won't get me anywhere. It's starting to slip down again. Okay, I think I got a firm grasp of it. And there we are. More plastic. And there we are. The Whitey Ford bobblehead from today's game. Very nice, very nice. And he was a pitcher. I believe he has the most wins for a starting pitcher in Yankees history. 40s, 50s, and maybe a little bit of 60s he played. After he was drafted, He was also drafted for the war, so he had to stop for a couple years. And, yeah, pretty cool. And, I don't know what this is. Oh, AT&T advertisement. Wonderful. But, yeah, that is pretty much it. Hope you guys enjoyed this. And I will see you guys next time. And also, if anyone cares, let's do a quick unboxing of the trading cards. Okay, I just got it. Get it out of the plastic. And there it is. It's a lot simpler than the bobblehead. Okay, so like I said, all of these are 2017, except for Jeter, which I guess is a little gimmick, because they put them right in the front of the box, just to sell it, just a gimmick to sell it. So there's Jeter, stats. We have Chase Headley. We have Dylan Betances. Hey, how these are sideways. We have Brett Gardner. Upside down. We have Gary Sanchez. I need to learn how to turn these the right way. We have Aaron Judge. I'm good at flipping these. We have Starlin Castro. We have CC Sabathia. Oh my, I can't. No matter what I try, I can't do it. We have Jacoby Ellsbury. DD Gregorius. Greg Bird. Michael Pineda. Tyler Austin, who is injured at the moment. Luis Severino. Aroldis Chapman. Matt Holliday, injured. And Masahiro Tanaka. And that's that. So now I will definitely see you.